Shyamananda Prabhu, Rasikanand Prabhu had that quality. When he used to sit near his guru, he would not talk in front of his guru. He would just look at the lotus feet of his Gurudev. So Shyamananda told this order to, and then he left. Then Rasikananda went to that place. Shyamananda wanted him to deliver this king Abdullah. So Rasikananda went. He came outside the town of, and he sat down under a tree. He was doing Hari Bhajan. Lakhs of people came to see him because of his bhakti, his prem. My dear Rasikananda, we pray to you only one thing. Don't go inside this town. This king will kill you. Every day he is killing so many people. Especially sadhus, he will kill you very fast. Don't go. Rasikananda said, it's my Gurudev's order. I have to go. So Rasikananda, even Rasikananda was a very dear associate of Radharani. Just before Rasikananda came to Shyamananda, Radharani appeared to Shyamananda in the dream. And Radhika said, oh Shyamananda, I am sending you my eternal associate. You give him Diksha. Rasikananda's Varana was like Shukadev Goswami. Like Uddhava. He was Sham Varana. Very, very beautiful. His hands were up to his knees. He came. He went inside the town. At that time, Abdullah thought, this sadhu is very popular. If I kill him directly, people may blame me. But I will make an idea. There is one mad elephant which comes out of the jungle every time, during this time. So I will let the elephant kill Rasikananda. Then he will also die and nobody will blame me. So Rasikananda was standing in front of the palace of Abdullah. Abdullah had gone up in the terrace to watch what the leelas are going on. And at that time, that mad elephant came. He destroyed the whole market. He was trampling so many people. When he was coming, he was killing and he was running. People said, Rasikananda, run, run, run. This elephant will kill you. Let him come. When the elephant was running and came before Rasikananda, Rasikananda looked in his eyes, the elephant. Pure devotee does not look at your body. Pure devotee looks at your soul, at your swaroop. When a pure devotee looks at you, he can see your swaroop. If he has realized his own swaroop. So he was looking at the elephant, and the elephant was looking at him. And then Rasikananda took out his finger and said, you are Krishna Das. You should not harm others. Krishna Das is very merciful on others. You should do Hari Bhajan. That words coming out from a pure devotee's mouth. Elephant. The vani of the pure devotee and the eyes, the darshan of the pure devotee and the proximity with the pure devotee. When you are near to a pure devotee, akshno phalam tvadrisha darshanam hi जिह्वा फलम त्वादृश कीर्तनम्। स्पर्श फलम त्वादृश अंग स्पर्शन। देयर इज वन वर्स इन द हरि भक्ति सुजोदय, द आईज आर परफेक्टेड बाय सीइंग द प्योर डिवोटीज ऑफ गौर कृष्ण। Our tongue is purified by glorifying the pure qualities of the pure devotees of Gaur Krishna. And our body is purified by touching their lotus feet. If you take bath in the Ganga, it will take a long time to remove all your sins. You have to take Gangate Parosho Hoile पश्चाते पावन दर्शने पवित्र करो ए तुमार घूम। यू हैव टू टेक रिपीटेड बर्थ इन द गंगा, बट इफ यू मीट अ प्योर डिवोटी यू आर इमीडिएटली प्यूरिफाइड। सो दैट डिवोटी has this symptom of sadhu ninda, the symptom of dayaluta, mercifulness, then sahishnuta, tolerance. Pure devotee is always tolerant, like a tree. You take a stone, and you throw it on the tree will get hurt, but the tree will give you its fruit. Taro riva sahishnuna. Such a merciful tree. You are hitting it and the tree is giving you fruit. Then you go to cut the tree, still the tree will give you shade. You are sitting, and if you cut the tree will give you its own body. Okay, take me. The tree will not protest. That is devotee. When Indra went to Dadichi to ask for his bones, give your bones, want to make that vajra, thunderbolt, to kill Vritrasur. Dadiji said, take my body. That is the Vaishnava, Saheshnuta. A real Vaishnava should never have any ego, should never take aparadh. That is why those who do aparadh are finished. Because when they do aparadh, the pure devotee does not take any aparadh. So Krishna becomes more angry. The Naam becomes more angry. Because a pure devotee forgives. Somehow, he is equal to everybody. Rich and poor, male and female, learned and foolish, good looking and bad looking, never differentiates. He is equal to everybody because he sees the soul. Droha dro shunyavra. He never takes revenge. Droha. Droham is revenge. A pure devotee never has a revengeful attitude. You have done this to me, I will do this to you. No, never. Satya Sar. Whatever he speaks is the truth. The absolute truth. Which will take you close to Krishna. Vishuddhatma. He is pure inside and outside. He doesn't waste time in activities of Maya. He's always your Parohite Roto. And his quality is always endeavoring to help others. Parahite Rato. Rato means absorbed in helping the jivas. Name ruchi jive doya. Vaishnava seva. These are the qualities of the pure devotee. Kame akshubhita buddhi dant akinchan mrudu ruchi parinit bhoji shantaman. Kame akshubhit. He is never engaged in lusty activities. Buddhi, dant, his senses are always under his control by the power of his naam, bhajan. All the senses are absorbed in the naam ras, so they never seek out any other thing. Akin chana. And he does not consider himself as the possessor of anything in this world. Akinchana. Akinchana. Gocharam. Tvam akinchana gocharam. Janma aishwarya shruta shribhir etaman. Madhakuma. Nahi vahartya vidhatum vai. Tvam akinchana gocharam. Kunti says that, O Krishna, you are the wealth of those who have nothing. Tvam akinchana gocharam. Because those who have everything in this world, they cannot call your name with feeling. Naiva hartya vidhatum vai. Tvamakin. Those who have big birth, those who have good looking, those who have very big knowledge, Janma Aishwarya, those who have a lot of opulence, they cannot call your name with feeling. They already think that they have everything. So, you are the property of the impoverished. Impoverished doesn't mean only externally. Impoverished means internally. You may be very rich externally, but internally, one should feel that one has nothing. Like Pundarik Vidyanidhi, Prem Nidhi. He was Rishabhanu from Krishna Lila. When Gadadhar Pandit went to meet him with Mukund, he was sleeping on a beautiful couch, silk couch, wearing a most beautiful silk dress. His buttons were full with diamonds. His hair had the most beautiful chandan, Malaya chandan oil, so fragrant. His bimba lips were red. And some people were giving him grapes to eat. He was eating grapes. He was like a king. Pundarik Vidyanidhi, he had everything. So opulent. So Gadadhar Pandit, for one moment, he got a doubt. Oh, so much opulence. Mukunda said he is a pure devotee. Can he really be? So Mukund understood the mind of Gadadhar. Pure devotees, they can understand each other's mind. So Mukundas recited one verse in front of Pundarik. Aho Bakiyam Stanakalakutam Jigam Shayadapyasadavi Lebe Gatim Datriuchitam Tatonyam Kim Vadayalum Sharanam Brajema. From the Bhagavatam, Shukadeva Goswami says, how much merciful is Krishna, that woman, that witch, Putana, who applied poison on her breasts, came to kill him. He sent her to Goloka and made her the assistant of Yashoda, Dhatri, nurse. How much merciful is Krishna? Because of her seva, trying to feed Krishna. When Pundarik Vidyanidhi heard this verse, he became mad. He said, Hari Bol!
Hari Bol!
He loudly roared. And all the grapes were flying in the air. He started pulling his hair. He started pulling his dress. All the his sevaks, these 10, they came, caught him, tried to catch him, but they could not catch him. He was jumping in the sky, falling down on the ground, huge sound produced. All the 10 people could not hold him. He was continuously crying, all his hairs standing on the end. He was telling Krishna, Krishna, you delivered Putana. You sent her to Goloka, but you are not, why am I still here? Asura sakala paila charana. Paila charana. असुर सकल पाइल चरण असुर सकल पाइल चरण विनोदे विनोदे ठाकिलो बोशी विनोदे ठाकिलो बोशी विनोदे Gopina Mama Nivedana Suno Mama Nivedana Suno Bhakti Vinod Thakur is also singing. All the demons have attained you and I am still bereft of your mercy. What a great miserable situation I am in. I am trying to do your bhajan, but still I am not getting prema. There is one verse in Chaitanya Chandramrit. It says, what is that verse? Sparshopi mama na kanam bhave. Oh Gaura Sundar, you have come and your mercy of your prema has inundated every town and village, every of this world, but that mercy has not even touched me. Even a drop of that mercy has not touched me, because still I cannot cry your name. My heart is so hard, I cannot cry your name, I cannot chant. Oh Lord, I am so unfortunate. There is no greater unfortunate people than us. We are not hankering for Krishna prem, so we are not getting it. So that aparad Gadadhar did in his mind to ask forgiveness for the aparad, Gadadhar Pandit thought it was a maha aparad. I did against a Mahabhagavat. So only way I will be forgiven for this aparad is that if I accept Diksha from Pundarik Vidyanidhi. Gadadhar Pandit accepted Diksha from Pundarik Vidyanidhi. Because in Krishna Leela, Pundarik was Vrishabhanu and Gadadhar was Radhika. So obviously Radhika will accept Diksha from Vrishabhanu. Their father and daughter in Krishna Leela. So Gadadhar Pandit became the disciple of Premanidhi or Pundarik Vidyanidhi. So the sadhu is always controlled and akinchan. Mridu, the sadhu is always very mild, very soft. Mridu Shuchi. Shuchi means the sadhu is pure inside and outside. Parimita Bhogji. Parimita Bhogji is one of the symptoms of a sadhu. A sadhu eats only that much prasadam which is required to maintain this body and the soul together. A sadhu does not engage in sense gratification in the name of prasad. Parimita bhoji. Madhavendra Puri did not even go to ask anybody. He would do bhajan wherever he used to go. It was ayachak vritti. Madhavendra Puri had ayachak vritti. Ayachak vritti means he would just go for bhajan and Mahaprasad would come to him. Whoever, whatever, if 3-4 days nobody would give him, he was happy. He was not asking anybody. That's why here in Govardhan, behind Govind Kund, is Madhavendra Puri's baithak. And Madhavendra Puri was he was fasting for almost 3 days or 4 days. Then Krishna himself came with a pot of milk. Because in Vraj Bhumi, nobody, if a real sadhaka goes hungry, then Krishna feels the pain. This Vraj Dham is Krishna himself. So, Parimita Bhoji and Shantamon, the sadhu's mind is very peaceful, like the sea, ocean. It is not agitated. Aniha, dhritimana sthir, krushna krushnai kasharan, apramatto sugambhir vijito shada gun. No, what happens? I think it's because of the voltage. छोटा माइक आने में हमारे अवर स्टेबिलाइजर थिंक इज छोटा माइक आ ची साइड इत आर माइक डब्बा. So, at this time the voltage becomes dim for some reason. But our hall is made in such a way that you don't need a speaker. You know, Hari Bol! I'm getting echo. So, Shanta Mon. Sadhu is always peaceful and Dhrutiman, very mature, and he always makes the right decisions, Thir, steady, and Krishnaika Sharan, always shelter, under the shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna. Apramatto, he is never intoxicated. Sugambhir, very, very grave. The sadhu is very grave. Vijito, shada guno. He has conquered all his six urges mentioned in Upadeshamrit. Vacho vegam manasa krodha vegam jivha vegam udara upastha vegam etan vegan yo vishaheta dhira sarvam abhimam prithvim shashishyat. He controls his six urges. Urge to speak, urge vacho vegam, urge of the mind to think bad thoughts, krodha vegam, urge to become angry, manasa krodh, jiva, the urge to eat, stomach, udar vegam, the urge to fill the stomach with nice food, and the udaropastha vegam, the urge of the genitals. The sadhu is controlling all these six urges. लाइट गेला आचे लाइट आचे कि नहीं
है लाइट है
किधर है लाइट
बिजली
ओके हरि बोल. Etan vegam yo vishahet dhir sarvam apimam prithvim shashishya. One who has controlled these six urges is qualified to make disciples all over the world. So one who is a guru should have conquered these six urges. Because if one has not conquered the six urges, then one will not become the guru of the disciple. One will become a servant of the disciple. Godas, not a Goswami. One will give the disciple what the disciple wants to please him, make him happy. So there are many gurus, many people in this world nowadays who are just after the wealth of the disciples. But there are very rare gurus who can remove the santap, who can remove the anxiety of the disciples by giving them the holy name. Bhavo guru shishya vitto paharakai sudurlabha guru shishya santap harakai. Amani manado daksha. Avanchako jnani ei sobo lakshane te sadhu boli jani. Amani, no respect, expectation from anybody. Manada, giving respect to everyone. Daksha, daksha means very expert in bhajan. Avanchaka, not expecting any things from others, not greedy. Jnani means learned. In the scriptures, the guru should be able, the sadhu should be able to give you the essence of the scriptures. That is a symptom of a sadhu. And all these symptoms, when they merge, then that devotee is known as sadhu. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. That devotee is known as sadhu. Ei sobo lakshano prabhu hai dvi prakar swarupa tatastha bhede kari bevichar. These symptoms are of two types, O Mahaprabhu. One is swarup lakshan and other is tatastha lakshan. And we will discuss this in the commentary. Bhakti Vinod Thakur writes, Je vastu rajaha sakshat nija lakshan tahai tahara swarup lakshan anya vastu sambandhe je aguk lakshan shei vastu ke udai hoy tahai tahara tatastha lakshan. Whatever is the internal property, the quality, is known as swarup lakshan. And that qualities which we manifest while talking with others or in relationship with others, that is known as tatastha lakshan. These are two kinds of qualities of a sadhu. Different ways. Either there are two kinds of bhakti also. Swarup siddha bhakti and arop siddha bhakti. Swarup siddha bhakti means shravanam kirtanam. And arop siddha bhakti means you eat prasadam. And you work to accumulate money, you earn money and then you use it for Krishna consciousness. That is known as Arop Siddha Bhakti. Swarup Siddha Bhakti is Shravanam and Kirtanam. Direct hearing, direct listening, direct chanting, Dhamvas, this is all Swarup Siddha Bhakti. They awaken our Swarup. So Vaishnav also has two symptoms, Swarup Siddha Lakshan and tatastha lakshan. Vaishnava krishnaika sharano haye swarup lakshan tatastha lakshano anya gane ro gano anya gune ro gano kona bhagye sadhu sange name ruchi haye krishna naam gaaye kore Krishna Padashray. By some good fortune, a soul will develop attraction for Krishna's name. Until the soul develops attraction for Krishna's name, the soul is not actually in bhajan, is not a sadhak. The sadhan starts when one develops attraction for Krishna Naam. And that soul, that jiva starts singing Krishna Naam and takes shelter of Krishna's lotus feet. Swarupa lakshana sehi hoite ahila gaite gaite naam anya guno asila. Very nice. The main sadhu sangha you do, the shravan kirtanam you do, that awakens your swarup lakshan. And when you start chanting the name, all other good qualities will come in you. You will become humble. You will become merciful. All these other qualities are known as tatastha lakshan. Secondary qualities. There is one verse in the Bhagavatam. Yashasti bhagavat bhaktira kinchana sarva gunai tatra samasate sura. When somebody chants Krishna Naam and does Krishna Bhakti, then gradually all qualities are attracted to that devotee and they come in the body of that devotee. Anya guna gano tai totosto ganon avashya vaishnava dehe hoye sangathon. All the other qualities are secondary qualities, and avashya means certainly they come in the body of a Vaishnava who is chanting the holy names. Varnashrama linga nana prakari vesh dwara sadhutva hoyena Krishna ko sharane sadhur lakshan. Varnashrama chinna nana veshiro rachana sadhur lakshan kabu na hoye ganana. The sadhu is not identified by any amount of external dress. A sadhu may put so many tilak everywhere, tilak. Sadhu may wear so many kanthi malas. Sadhu may wear all kinds of symptoms. But externally, that does not determine a sadhu. These are not the identifying symptoms of a sadhu. Sri Krishna Sharanagati Sadhur Lakshan Taro Mukhe Hoye Krishna Naam Sankirtan. To that extent that devotee is surrendered to the lotus feet of Krishna, to that extent that jiva is a sadhu. Especially to the extent in which from his mouth nama sankirtan is coming. Nama sankirtan. The more nama sankirtan manifests, the more that devotee becomes a sadhu. So if you want to know who is a sadhu, very easy. You find out that who has taste in the name. Nama Sankirtan. Those who has more taste in the Naam, bigger sadhu. Jaro jato name ruchi taro tato vaishno. Taro tato vaishno. Gruhi brahmachari vanaprastha nyasi bhed. Shudra Vaishya Shatra Vipra Ganera Prabhe. Grihi Brahmachari Vanprastha Sannyasi. These are the four ashrams, and the four varnas are Shudra, Vaishya, Kshatriya and Brahmana. So this does not have any significance whether one is a Brahmana or a Kshatriya or a Vaishya or a Shudra or a Grihastha, Brahmachari, Vanprastha or Sannyasi. Sadhakatva kakhon nahi hoibe nirnit Krishna hi kasharana sadhu sa strete vidhi. Krishna hi kasharana. This word is coming again and again here. In Harinam Chintamani, it means surrender to the lotus feet of Krishna. Aika, Krishna hi kam is only Krishna, exclusive surrender, unalloyed surrender to Krishna's lotus feet. That is a sadhu. The sadhu does not have to be a sannyasi or a grihastha, vanprastha. Does not matter. Gruhi sadhu ralakshan. What is the symptom of a grihastha devotee? Gruhi sadhu lakshan ki. Raghunath dase laksha koriya se sevar. Gruhi sadhu jane shikhyache e sar. Raghunath das Goswami was the ideal sadhu when he was a grihastha. Raghunath das kayasth kul tilak saptagram vasi das Goswami boliya jini hoy choy Goswami ra madde pari gonito. It's already. Sthir hoye dhore jabe na hoye batul krome krome paelo bhavasindhu ku. The main symptom of a sadhu, a grihastha, of a grihastha bhakta is that sadhu should be patient, dhairya. A grihastha bhakta should always be patient. One should not jump, one should not rush. Krame krame paye lok bhavasindhu ko. Sthir hoye ghore jaye na hoye batu. Raghunath Das Goswami wanted to meet Gauranga very, very much, but he returned to his home and he acted as if he was a normal householder. But gradually he became free from all entanglements and he came to Jagannath Puri. So a grihastha bhakta should not be too much anxious. Grihastha bhakta should be very patient, gradually develop Krishna consciousness, taste for the holy name, be peaceful instead of making rash decisions. Morkata vairagya chhad lok dekhaiya yatha yogya vishay bhunj anasakta hana. Morkata vairagya means the renunciation of a monkey. Monkey making a big show. Monkey does not wear any clothes. Monkey jumps from one tree to the another. He does not even any house. Monkey does not have any house. The monkey eats some berries and fruits. But the monkey is always thinking about sex life. When he will meet the female monkey. So, markat vairagya, grihastha should not leave the family just like that. Loka dekhaiya, just to show to the world how renounced I am. See, I left my family, I left my children, I have left everything. One should not leave that just to show to the world. Till the time Krishna shows you the right way, Gurudev shows you the right way, one should remain in the grihastha ashram and yatha yogya vishaya bhunja. One has to do some activities, materialist, apparently vishaya bhunja, little bit. One has to be responsible for the family. Hmm. and have some level of aropsiddha bhakti to maintain the body and soul together. Antare nishtha karo bahe lok vyavhar, achire krishna tumar koribe uddhar. These are the direct verses from Chaitanya Charitamrita, which Gauranga has spoken to Raghunath Das Goswami. He tells Raghunath Das, when you are a grihastha, you have very strong faith inside your heart that you will attain Krishna, and externally you act like a householder. You do your bhajan, but don't artificially renounce. Don't do markat vairagya. And if you stay in this position, very soon Krishna will deliver you, show you the way. Shri Krishna tomai koribe uddhar. Last, today we'll see a commentary given to this by Bhakti Vinod Thakur. Antare vairagyo vishaye nishtha janme nahi akhach kopin bahirvasadi bhaiyo dharan kara hoy ihai morkot vairagyo chin. Internally, if you have not developed renunciation, nishtha, if you have not developed strong faith in renunciation and you give up everything, you give up your family life and you accept kaupin and the dress of a renunciant, then that is known as markat vairagya. It is known as not true vairagya. So Harinam Chintamani is so beautiful to explain to us what is sadhu ninda. Haridas Thakur is explaining to us who is a sadhu. So now we thought, so a grihastha sadhu. Tomorrow we will see who is a grihatyagi sadhu. What is the quality of a renunciant sadhu? We will see tomorrow. And then we will see that what is the swarup lakshana of both of them. Thank you very much. Shri Harinam Chintamani ki jai. Any questions? Radha Kundashtami, yeah, Bahulashtami. It has many names. Yeah, it is also known as Radha Kundashtami. Tomorrow is the 26th. No, tomorrow is the 25th. So it is day after tomorrow. Actually, I'll just tell you that there is a difference between our Gaudiya calendar and the local Vrajvasi calendar, because we follow moon light and they follow solar. Smartha calendar is different than our Gaudiya calendar. So the local Vrajvasis here are celebrating the appearance day of Radha Kund starting from 3 p.m. on 26th onwards. The 12 o'clock midnight snan, where thousands and millions come, that will be done in Radha Kund on 26th night, midnight. And the Ashtami Tithi, according to this local calendar, Brajavasi calendar, will go up to 3 p.m. on 27th. So if you want to take the snan, Radha Kund snan is the snan dan. On the birthday of Radha Kund, the biggest seva is we offer our snan dan by taking bath in Radha Kund and reciting the Radha Kripa Kataksh Stotra, reciting Radha Kund Ashtakam. Not only it is the appearance day of Radha Kund, but it is also the appearance day of Sham Kund. It is the birthday of both the Kundas. And according to us, these Kundas are more merciful than Radhesham themselves. So we actually fast. Technically, I don't know anybody who fasts, but I myself don't eat grains. Like a Ekadashi fast. And our fast will be starting from 27th morning. Because according to our Gaudiya calendar, the Bahulashtami, Ashtami is on 27th morning. So 27th morning till 28th morning, that is the Ashtami. We believe the Tithi starts from morning. Whereas in the Smartha calendar, the Tithi is starting at 3 p.m., the Ashtami, and it is ending next day on 27th at 3 p.m. So if you want to be safe that you have taken bath in Ashtami, then you can take bath on 26th night at 2 a.m. Because at 12 midnight, you can't go there. It is too much rush. But especially for Matajis, it's difficult to go at midnight. So after 1:30, 1 o'clock, 1:30, then all the rush is good. The kunda is like, becomes open. So you can take bath on 26th day after tomorrow night at 1 a.m., 1:30. And then you can take bath next day morning also, because that is also Ashtami if you want. Next day morning, because our Gaudiya Tithi starts from 27th morning. So you can, after sunrise, you can take bath that time. And then third bath you can take on 27th midnight. Fortunately, 27th midnight is nobody will, there will be no so much rush, because everybody takes bath on 26th night. So you can take bath on 27th night, midnight. So then you will be covering all the snans possible. And then you should fast, and if possible you should remain awake in the night on Ashtami. Morning try to get up early before sunrise, Brahma Murta, and take morning bath in Radha Kund. Offer ghee lamp to Radha Kund. Devki Parandas has invited us at 4:30 p.m. On 26th evening. He is lighting all the lamps. Radha Kund, he is doing the Deep Dan Seva. So he is telling that he is not having devotees this time. Many devotees have not come for Seva. So he is inviting us, that all of you come to the Kunda and help in the Deep Dan Seva for 1 hour. One and a half hour on 26th. So we will see, maybe we will do that seva and then come here and have katha or something like that. Because that time is the katha time, 26th. Deep Dan Seva on 26th. And here, the glories of Radha Kund. Read that book, books about Radha Kund, which are written by the acharyas, and beg to Radharani. If possible, you should read Kripa Katak Stotra 100 times in the water of Radha Kund to seek the mercy and the darshan of Radharani. And yes, I will explain you about Radha Kund on that day. We'll have katha on 26th onwards. Means tomorrow will be the katha on Chaitanya Charitamrita and Harinam Chintamani, and day after tomorrow we will have Radha Kund Lila katha for 2 days, 26th and 27th, morning and evening both. I'll describe to you the holy places around Radha Kund and what are the Kunda Leela's manifestation, Leela by Jeeva Goswami, Acharyas. Thank you very much. Sri Radha Kunda ki jai, Sham Kunda ki jai. Upar hai rakhi bhai, upar. Upar.